Hey, Brian from SnakeBytes here. There's so many things that fascinate me about reptiles, and you have to ask yourself, why do snakes have scales? We're gonna spend some time talking about it, and everyone's favorite, Chewy's gonna get bit by a whole bunch of animals. You're watching SnakeBytes. We all know that snakes have scales, but do we ever stop to think about what they're actually there for? They have a bunch of different purposes, no more important than protecting the animal. It's almost like a leathery armor. They protect them from prey as well as predators. After protection, one of the most important purposes for scales is to aid in locomotion. I'm sure you've noticed that snakes' belly scales are different than the ones on their back. Those are called ventral scales, and they're much larger, which helps reduce friction. Let's face it, snakes are kind of lazy, so anything that can help save energy is pretty important to them. Snakes that are from arid or desert areas, like these Kenyan sand boas, have scales that actually can aid in hydration by keeping moisture in. Snakes even have scales over their eyes called spectacles. It actually helps them protect them from when they're climbing to not get scratched by branches and stones like that, and they actually shed them off every time they shed. Believe it or not, a baby snake is hatched with the exact same amount of scales it's going to have its entire life. Obviously, as it gets bigger, the scales are going to grow and sometimes will even change shape a little bit. Believe it or not, snake scales are made of keratin, the same material as our fingernails and hair. And what's interesting is you can identify a species by the amount of scales in a row. Certainly one of the most important reasons for scales is to cover the brightly covered skin and actually camouflage the animals. Take for instance these Brazilian rainbows. They have a really smooth scale that's actually extremely iridescent. And as you can see, they would actually come from an area very similar to this mulch, and they blend in very well so predators wouldn't even see them, or even the prey that was running by, they could ambush it that way. Now, on the completely opposite spectrum from the Brazilian rainbow boas that have that smooth, iridescent look to them, these gopher snakes actually have a really heavily keeled scale, and they're almost beaded-like looking, and you can actually hear from the hiss of this animal. If you were in the wild, you may actually think it's a rattlesnake because that's what it's trying to mimic. Again, that goes back to another purpose for scales. Sometimes it's not always about camouflage, but actually mimicking other animals as well. Speaking of rattlesnakes, the rattle on a rattlesnake is actually just scales. They're born with only one rattle that's called a button, and every time they shed, they'll add one more rattle to it. Talking about all these scales and snakes, you guys know I have to bring up the scaleless corn snakes and rat snakes. It's really weird to think of a snake that doesn't have scales, but what is kind of interesting, going back to the locomotion part, is all scaleless corn snakes and rat snakes actually still have ventral scales, so it helps with their locomotion. Now, these animals really probably wouldn't live well in the wild at all because they don't have any camouflage, they don't have any protection. But in captivity, we've been keeping these for years, and as long as you don't feed them live rodents, they do just as well as any other snake with scales, and they look pretty darn cool.
All right, guys, it's Kel's question of the week. Biting. Everybody loves watching somebody else get bit. It's just never fun for the person getting bit. I want to know from you guys, tell me a story about an experience where you got bit, whether it be by an animal or crazy ex-girlfriend. Text your video comment below. Let me know. All right, guys, it's pretty obvious that Chewy right here seems to get bit more than the rest of us. And I'm starting to wonder if it's the snakes or if Chewy actually has like a predisposition for getting bit by anything. So we're going to go ahead and test this theory. Start with snakes.
Ow, that's my pinky. Ow. Quit squeezing. Door.
Snakes, check. Let's try some leopard geckos.
Come here, little gecko.
Photo obvious. The leopard gecko test, I'm afraid.
Ow!
Let's try an albino Pac-Man frog. Let's try something that's not a reptile.
That's not what they're like when you
mosquito. All right, guys. Well, I think it speaks for itself. Chewy got bit by a snake. Got bit by a dog. Got bit by a mosquito. He got bit by a leopard gecko. He got bit by a frog. I mean, the guy just gets bit by everything. It's plain to see.
What else is there? Ow!
Ow!
Holy!
Hurt!
For this week's Comment of the Week on the Crocodile Dundee What episode, the question was, what's the most dangerous animal you've ever handled? And TK Reptile said,
well, the most dangerous animal I've ever handled, and I have to be super careful saying this, is a female Mexican girlfriend. Yeah, she is one dangerous animal. I'm scared to even write this right now. But let me tell you, I handled her like a champ.
Oh yeah, the dreaded Mexican girlfriend. You gotta be really careful of those ones. Until next time, you guys keep sending me creative comments. I'm gonna feature you on a future episode. So there it is. I hope you guys enjoyed the show and learned a little bit about the reasons why snakes have scales. And hey guys, we're wrapping up our first month of the Member of the Month contest over on our community site. We're going to announce next week the first winner and show the cool prizes that Reptology and Reptiles Magazine donated. You guys can't win if you don't join. So make sure you go to snakebytestv.ning.com and do it right away. This has been Snake Bytes.